Dear Conquerors, this is Dr. Kalyani from Team MDS Conquer. Today we will be talking about the topic regeneration. So repair and regeneration are the end products of laps or whatever periodontal surgery you do. Either it ends with repair or there is a regeneration. So what is regeneration? It is a natural renewal of a structure produced by growth and differentiation of new cells and intercellular substances to form new tissues. So it is main important is the same type of tissue or from its precursor. Now coming to repair, what is repair? It is just restoring the continuity of the disease and it means a healing by scar. So all our regenerative procedures where we use GTR only leads to regeneration. Rest everything, scaling root planing, curettage, gingival surgical techniques, flap surgeries, whatever modified Widman, whatever, everything comes under repair. So most of it is repair. So here we can see that two possible outcomes. In the first case, like before treatment, the sulcus is reduced till here and it is still healthy. That means it is repair, it is healed but with a scar. But here you can see it is well adapted, new formation of connective tissue fibers almost to the length. So this is regeneration and this is our hero. This is what we aim for. Let's see how much we achieve when we try and how do we have to do this regeneration. What happens? So for this regeneration, we have there's a concept called as Melchior's concept. I'll be explaining you. Before that, let's see what is new attachment. New attachment, very important. These terms have to be on your tips because they will ask you like this. If it is the embedding of new periodontal ligament fibers into new cementum and the attachment of the gingival epithelium to a tooth surface previously denuded by disease is called option A, new attachment, option B, reattachment, number C, repair, number D, all the above. So you have to go for new attachment. Because and most important term is tooth surface previously denuded by a disease. That means a patient already had a disease and then you have tried to achieve a new attachment. That's most important. Then reattachment. Reattachment is nothing. It is passively adapting the gingiva to that of the sulcus like this. Okay, it is that's all. There is no attachment, nothing. Repair in areas of root not previously exposed to pocket is called as reattachment. That means in the cases where you treated not for a pathology, like for in case of your tooth fracture or in periapical lesions treatments, so no pocket, perio problem is not there, but still you had to do some procedure, then you get a reattachment. Next, so this is the definition of reattachment. These are very beautiful terms. Every term would be given as a bit. And you should know the real words from that which you can pick. Epithelial adaptation. It differs from new attachment in that it is just a close apposition like how I have told you. Come, this is the image of epithelial adaptation. Okay. Now, this is laser assisted. So, earlier we have learnt about new attachment procedure, right? Which was for new US Naval Dental Corps during, it's a kind of subgingival curettage. Now, we are learning about LNAP. Recently people feel LNAP is a very beautiful procedure, so but I don't know how far it is successful, but you see here it is the role of a laser in periodontal therapy. NDR laser is used for it. So flap is raised, laser is passed by it, and after that you can also do a osseous recontouring of the tooth here. This is what it's all about, LNAP. Now coming to guided tissue regeneration. That means guided tissue. The tissue is guided by something to regenerate. It is not happening on itself. Something is guiding it. That is about guided tissue regeneration. Go through these points. And this is about the image of guided tissue regeneration. Okay. Let's see the beautiful concept behind it. So this is it's like a story. When you have when a parents are looking for a perfect match for a beautiful girl, they will look for all the regular people. That's how we are looking for our proper new attachment procedure. Okay, so that is that we are equal to the parents in the story. Now we are trying to search for a good match. So we have four proposals here. Okay. Number one is the proposal from the bone. One is proposal from epithelium. One more proposal is from that connective tissue. One is from the PDL cells. So actually, for us to produce a beautiful new attachment, we need PDL cells. Okay, we don't want bone, epithelium, connective tissue. But for PDL to come, before that, these people will come. Okay, so we have to stop these people from getting the best match for the girl. So what we do first, like how a father judges the guys, first epithelium comes to us and then we have to say no, epithelium we don't want, because if epithelium is coming, what will form? Long junctional epithelium. So we will end up with having a long junctional epithelium. We will not get new attachment. So epithelium is cancelled. So we have to stop epithelium from coming. Okay, one more thing. Then connective tissue cells will come. They'll say, okay, I will form because I will help you in forming this resorptions and all. So no, connective tissue will come. You will have resorption. So cancel connective tissue. Then bone. If bone is coming, you will have ankylosis. Bone will think, okay, I'm the stronger one. I will come. I will adapt to the as for the new attachment. Bone will. But what we ideally want is PDL. Why do we want PDL? Because PDL has a capacity of generating to all the things. It can give new fibers, it can give new connective tissue, it can give new epithelium, it can give new bone, everything it can form. That is the property of PDL. So for us, that has to come, we put a barrier, we envelop. That particular thing is nothing but guided tissue membrane, GTR membrane. So this concept of marriage, okay, is given by Melcher. So it is called as Melcher's concept. So it is marriage by Melcher's concept. That's how you remember. So our hero is PDL cells. So these are the other scientists who have done it. Then this GTR membrane is given by Gottlob. G for GTR, G for Gottlob. Okay, coming to Reschnitt. So new attachment has to come. So placing a barrier for a better results. So as I have already told you, if you can see here, this is the long junctional epithelium. Here is a repair. Connective tissue is coming. Root resorption is seen. If you again root resorption and ankylosis is seen. So ultimately, this is the only part where you get regeneration when PDL cells come. So here it is a competition between the epithelial cells, cancel, connective tissue cells, cancel, bone cells, cancel. Only this has to come. But our problem is these cells, you know, whichever is good, that takes time. So before this come, all these fellows will come. So you have to protect. Something has to be there. So when you put a layer like this, from this layer, or even they come, they can't enter inside. So one space is created. So generally, this is like you have three chairs. You know, you have, like for example, you have four guests and you have only one chair, okay, at your home. You want this, only this guest to come. So what you do? You try to preserve this chair for your most important guest. That's how we are preserving this space. That is Melcher's concept, very important. Moving on to objectives of GTR, to stabilize the blood clot, creating the sufficient space, exclude the cells, the negative cells, preference to the cells that are beautiful and repopulate. That's all, you know everything about GTR now. Moving on to the properties, I just go through, make a note all these properties. Indications. Now where do we need it? We need where the result is good, like very important again. Okay, see here, sorry, let's move on. See, it's most important is intra bony defect, deep and narrow, class 2 furcation, circumferential indications. Where other indications, these are major: ridge augmentation, coverage of root recession, repair episectomies, osseous fill and osseous defects. Coming to contraindications, where opposite to the indications: one wall defects, generalized horizontal bone loss, premolar furcations, or inadequate zone of attachment. All these are contraindications. These are the advantages and disadvantages when you do this particular procedure. Okay, coming to GTR. GTR is of three members: first generation, second and third generation. First generation is given, all this classification is given by Gottlob. According to him, first generation are non-resorbable. That is like millipore, EPTFE, all this. Okay, moving on to next, second generation is bioresorbable. These are the natural and synthetic. So these are the natural sources, these are the synthetically produced. Okay, coming to third generation, this Minibi has added this to the first and second, where you resorbable will have growth factors along with it. Like in 1991 it was given, it is non-resorbable and resorbable. This is the example, this is the image of a how a collagen membrane looks like. You don't have to actually go through all this. Only thing is this, I wanted to show you how, what kind of membranes are seen. Okay, this is a titanium mesh which is made up of titanium metal, and these are all the advantages and the uses about titanium mesh. Okay, so advantages of absorbable barriers. So the main thing is, once they are absorbed, you don't have them to remove them from the site. So it is not requirement of secondary surgeries. It reduces the operatory time. Obviously, patient will like it. Reduce risk of loss of regenerated attachment. Also, when you do a re-entry, there is always a problem. That is why. Tissue friendly and integrates with the host tissue. So all these are the advantages. Disadvantages. So poor visibility when the material is wet. When you place, you have a problem in handling it. So they tend to collapse because of the soft texture, and they also tend to have allergic reactions. This is about those Melcher's concept which I explained you. You can have a look at it. This is again the repetition of the same slide. So how do you evaluate that you've got a new attachment or not? Number one is you do it through a surgical re-entry. You do it through a surgical re-entry. Then you check it through your probing, then you take radiographs to check it, then ultimately you have to extract the tooth, take a part of it, histological evaluation. So all these three are the methods to check. Number one is probing. Number two is in this way, like you re-entry, surgical re-entry, then radiographs, then this is number four is again histological evaluation. Okay, make a note of all this. Moving on to the classification. So bone grafts are classified as auto, isograft, allograft, alloplast, xenografts and composite grafts. So if it is extraoral or intraoral origin, you select. Allografts of the same species are DFDBA, FDBA and frozen bone grafts. Alloplastic, which are made synthetically, hydroxyapatite, beta tricalcium phosphate, all these are alloplast. And xenografts are bovine derived, porcine derived and calcium, coralline calcium carbonate. Coming to cortical bone chips, all you do is you take some own chips. Okay, the bone will be cut into small pieces, or you take with a file, bone file, and you use it for your grafting. Second thing is osseous coagulum, given by Robinson. According to that, what he means is bone dust and blood. Bone is made into small dust and it is mixed with blood to give a osseous coagulum. Next, bone blend. What is bone blend? Bone blend means it differs from bone dust. There you have taken bone dust and blood. Here what you're doing, bone is blended properly into small pieces, workable mass, by using some saline into it. Now, cancellous bone marrow transplants, also this is their tuberosity, edentulous sites, which you take that and transplant into USR. And bone swagging, that means you are not taking a graft like that, the pedicel will be remaining and one bone will be moved on to the other side of a surface, like how it is attached. Now from extraoral surfaces also you can take the bone. Okay, so that's all about the regeneration. Thank you all.